ETNZ.
Well, for those of you who missed it, we're just sitting here headed back into port, beautiful Alicante, Spain. I'm with Grant Dalton, the CEO of Emirates Team New Zealand. I think the world's largest sailing team now, isn't that right?
Yeah, we probably are, actually. We're certainly not the world's most funded sailing team, but we're probably the largest.
Always pleading poverty on as we cruise around on the super yacht here. your team, though, obviously very well prepared. I know you guys have been working your ass off. I know everyone's really excited. Nico is excited. And yesterday, just mopping the floor with the fleet. But today, one mistake, really.
Wow. Probably two obvious ones. I mean, the breeze went left up that first kind of lay, and I thought we were going pretty quick to hang in. You know, we were in the right a little bit, and to hang in the left, or with the breeze going left. So all day I thought our speed was pretty good. Abu Dhabi looked quite slippery down that first run, but it's dead smooth water and bugger all breeze, so you can't read too much into it. But then it was rich got richer,
right,
and we managed to sail ourselves off the back of it. And then I think almost with sheer speed get back into third. So, crikey, three quarters of the way through the race, I would have bought out with a third any time.
So a third, and you know what? It's something that we've seen obviously with Dean and the AC45s. No one seems better able to come back from the mistakes than you guys.
Well, it's not something that we've had time to practice in these things. But maybe it's hopefully a bit of culture within the place, you know. But there was no breeze. Yeah. So I don't think you can read too much into it. The points still count, but you can't read anything into pace.
Right. And they're obviously valuable points. I'm talking about sort of going down the track a little ways. You know, plenty of controversy about your headstay system, which was ruled legal. It allows you guys to control rake on your mast that no one else really can. Now that we're at the point where, you know, there aren't a lot of big changes left to do, anything else that you guys have in the bag that's that the other guys might not?
Nah, nothing. You know, the boats are all got their new sails on today. They're all measured. They're all locked down. That's it. You get what you get now, and one of these things will be quicker. And I thought the 1K baits may look a little sticky in the light, but you just look at them in the dock, and yeah, they will.
Right.
Because you get nothing for nothing, you know. You might be sticky in the light and go like a raped ape on a reach. They're quite bow up or stern down. So, no one. It was a full, you know, you got, the show was there today. Nothing, no one's hiding anything, bet that, you know, bloody tough race because there's no wind.
What do you think about the show itself? Obviously this is a show. You know, no one who goes and sails world championships would look at this and go, that was a great race. You know, but it was out there, and the people are out there, and the HDTV, and hundreds of thousands of people around the world watching it. Is it worth doing?
Well, it seems to be a bit where the sport's going, and you can agree or disagree with that, but it doesn't seem quite right to have a race without a beat. And we just, you know, there was a long and a short, but the short was only about 5 boat lengths, so that doesn't really tell you anything about. I can't see. In this town, they're out on the water. They're not going to be necessarily particularly on the beach. It was raining earlier this morning, so I was surprised when I get to find we weren't having a proper full-on beat, you know, which is more important tactically and all those sorts of things.
Yeah. We had one of our readers, Alpina, ask, you know, if you got to run, you can always go run, you know?
Sounds like the greatest thing.
It's a
game for a
horse.
Horse day.
So the protest continues, the never-ending protest on your rake system.
Except, you know, we were setting up for this, at least a year ago, probably longer. So it's not really a surprise to us. So we talked a lot about staying completely calm and focused through the process, knowing that they would do this. So arguably they'll get way more bunched than us.
But theoretically, let's say you were to get ruled against, you can just go to the pin system and not really suffer, right?
Yeah, absolutely. So we've got a plan B too, but we knew we were right, and the arbitration panel just tossed the thing out, completely just tossed it out. I'd be a little surprised then if a jury, which is now the idea, is, well, if the arbitration panel won't rule against us, maybe we'll get the jury, or for us, against us, for them, maybe we get the jury too, but they're clutching at straws.
Grant, one of our readers, obviously people are fascinated by the size of your program now and all these different things you have going on. And obviously the two biggies are this one and the cup. What feeds what? Do they both feed each other? And how do you decide where the most resources go?
Well, they fed each other early on when we were designing Volvos and Volvo boat and putting the team together. And that was a process of trying to keep us together, you know, give us a project. They don't really feed each other now. I noticed through the night, last night a whole bunch of emails came into the boys from Dean and Gio and all the guys wishing them luck, but that's about as far as it goes now. Shub and myself are across both projects. The accountant is across both projects, but well, the rules guys are against across both projects, but they're pretty separated at this point.
Yeah.
And they need to be, because the Volvo is such a huge project all by itself, and so is the America's Cup. I mean, there's a huge amount of focus now on the America's Cup for us.
Yeah. When we spoke on the phone in a long interview a few months back, we talked about who's going to end up in the 72s. I know you guys are busy designing and figuring out how long it's going to take you to build yours. We also had a big Luna Rossa announcement, and it looks like they're in there confirmed. How does that change your thoughts? Do you think they'll make it all the way to San Francisco in 2013?
Yeah, I think Luna Rossa will go all the way, but I think that's it. They're a bolter, so they make three challenges, and I don't know who the fourth one is. And before I only thought there'd be two, but Luna Rossa's a bolter. So I haven't changed my opinion. I mean, we're finding that this is more expensive than we thought. That the boats are going to take longer to build than we thought.
So your budget to build the 72 has already gone northward?
Yeah, quite a lot north actually. And I don't think it's because we under budgeted. Well, ultimately we did. It's just that we're finding that there's something like 60,000 hours, and that's in the sophistication of building them in New Zealand where it happens quickly.
To build one boat?
Yeah, build one
and
boat.
And wing, obviously.
Yeah, boat and wing. In fact, as Shub was saying earlier, the wing takes longer to build than the old version 5 boats.
The entire boat.
So you can build two. You get six version 5 boats for two cats. I mean, that's saving money.
Well, but on the other hand, that's 3-1, whereas the speed ratio is something like 4 or 5-1, right?
Yeah, but it doesn't quite meet the criteria of saving money, does it?
I don't think when Larry Ellison came to the table, I don't think saving money really, if you understood what's going on, I don't think anyone really thought that was going to happen, did you?
And I get that, but don't say it. Don't try and make people believe it, because it's just rubbish, and it always was from day one, you know?
Well, you know, and I hope sort of the media picks up on the fact that, you know, whatever you think about the next cup, you got to look at what people are doing rather than what they're saying to evaluate whether it's a success or not, right?
We'll judge that at the end. Let's see how many are standing this time next year.
Let's see. I know I love seeing Luna Rossa there. I'd love to see, you know, I'd love to see a Frenchman come through and be in the mix too. And I'd be happy with that. That'd be interesting to me, you know.
Yeah, late though. I don't know. Luna Rossa is really late, and then you know they'll be aware of that. It's real late. It's just the sophistication of building these boats. We're just scrambling, and we've been going for designing for a year, and we're about to start building, but we are scrambling to work out how to build it with a team that's been together for a year. They're really, really tricky boats.
Is there any discussion about you sharing some of your work with Luna Rossa?
Yeah, we've talked about it a bit.
And?
We'll wait and see.
All right, Grant, hey, thanks for having me on the Imagine beautiful 100-foot alloy yachts built down in New Zealand, I reckon. And
yeah, it's not raining. At least it's not raining now, huh? Should have was horrible.
Hey, look, it's a beautiful day. Now. It's 25 degrees Fahrenheit. It's 0 degrees in my house, so this is just fine, man. Thank you very much.
Pleasure.
Yeah, nice job on the third place.
Well, yeah.